May 12th through the 18th, the United States Department of Health and Human Services Substance Abuse and Mental Health Services Administration holds National Prevention Week. As part of this national program to increase public awareness of mental health and substance use disorders, several suicide prevention community training sessions were held throughout the Muscogee Creek Nation jurisdiction by the MCN Department of Health. Muscogee Vision spoke with MCN Behavioral Health Grant Project Coordinator Tyler Stone about the QPR training.
So we know that in the state of Oklahoma, there's roughly, per 100,000 people, there's about 20 people who die by suicide per 100,000 people for Native Americans, which is the second leading, or which is the second race ethnicity in Oklahoma, the first being whites and non-Hispanics. So we know that suicide is a huge issue for Native Americans. Between 2003 and 2014, there was about 1,500 Native Americans who died by suicide. Now that number can be underreported, it could be much higher, because oftentimes when a suicide occurs and they do the death report, they may not know if that individual is Native American if they don't look ethnically Native. So we know that that number can be underreported. We know that Native Americans, some of the leading risk factors for suicide are substance abuse, interpersonal issues such as marital or relationship conflicts. And we also know that having a history of suicidal thoughts or having a plan is among the highest as well. So those are some of the risk factors that we talk about in some of our trainings that we do called QPR. QPR stands for Question, Persuade, and Refer. It's a 1-hour suicide prevention training that we provide for everyone. We work a lot with the hospital, we work with tribal departments, we open it up to community members as well. We believe that suicide is everyone's business, and we believe that you don't have to be an expert to help prevent suicide. We believe that everyone plays an important role in saving the lives of other people who are struggling. So in this 1-hour training, what we do is we go over some statistics, and we also break down the Q and the P and the R. The Q stands for question. So we're wanting to teach people, how do I approach and how do I ask the question, are you thinking about killing yourself? Now that's very scary to think about, and a lot of times we believe that if we ask somebody if they're feeling suicidal, then we might plant that idea in their head, or we might kind of push them over the edge. But what we found in the research is that if people are feeling suicidal, then us asking about their suicidality is only going to open up those lines of communication, lower that anxiety. It's gonna make them feel less isolated. So I'll give you an example. If you lose, let's say, a family member in whatever way, and you take a week off work and you come back to work and your face, you're still kind of struggling, right? You may be sulking at work. You may be obviously depressed, right? And let's say that nobody acknowledges that you're feeling sad, and they've kind of moved on and they expect you to move on too. That's gonna make you possibly feel a little more isolated, and maybe that somebody may not care. Well, that's what's going on with people who are feeling suicidal or having depression or anxiety or any kind of mental health disorder. So it's actually best for us to acknowledge that they're suffering and ask them about that, and then persuade them to get the help that they need. And that's where the P comes in. So we're persuading them to get help, to seek help, whether we're taking them to get that help, whether we're giving them resource information, but we're wanting them to get the help that they need. At least go and get checked out and just see, get a psych eval or get a suicide assessment done, just kind of see what's going on. And then the referral part is we teach people how to refer somebody to help. And the best method that we do is we take them directly to somebody who can help. This can include outpatient services such as behavioral health here at the tribe. This could be the hospital. If you're non-native, this can be Cree Oaks, this can be somebody in Tulsa, such as Shadow Mountain or Laureate or Parkside. There's a ton of different resources out there. So that's kind of in a nutshell what we talk about with QPR, is just letting people know that it is scary and it is kind of a heavy topic to talk about, but having a little bit of extra knowledge can help make the difference. Our number is 918-758-1930. Or you can call 918-758-1910 if you can't reach us at the 1930 number. just give us a call and let us know that you're interested in being trained in QPR. We offer them all the time. We don't always offer community-based ones, but if we have enough people, then we will. So every year we do a National Prevention Week. So we'll do one or two QPR trainings in each county, and we'll just offer it to the community and say, if you want to get trained in it, come on out. But if we don't have any of those trainings that are available, give us a call. We can set something up and get some people trained. So for National Prevention Week, each day kind of focuses on a different preventative method, whether it's underage drinking, whether it's tobacco prevention. The grant that I work for, we focus on suicide prevention. So in the past, what we've done is we've always had the two QPRs we've done in Milwaukee County. But this year I thought, why don't we expand this and reach some of our other audience? Because we always do a lot of work here in Milwaukee because we're based in Milwaukee. But we have such a huge service area, let's expand out. Let's get out as far as we can. So what we are able to do is we attend monthly coalition meetings in most of the counties that we serve. So what we've been able to do is just collaborate with them and say, hey, can we borrow your building? Can you guys help us promote this through some of your channels? Since you guys are embedded in these communities, how can we get the word out? And that's kind of what we've done for this year, is just really expand it as much as we can. At the end of Prevention Week, what we do is, this is the third annual 5K health and wellness run that Native Connections and Tobacco Prevention and Milwaukee County TSEP Healthy Living Program, and they've just kind of grown since the first year. It was just a simple little fun run 5K, but this year it's both of those things, plus some cultural games, plus a resource fair, so it's a lot bigger event. It's just growing and growing, and that's kind of what we end Prevention Week every year with, is a big, you know, 5K, 1 mile fun run, and always making sure that we provide resources for people that come out, so. And goodies and stuff like that as well. So the two that we promote the most is the crisis text line, which is 741-741. You text the word CREEK to 741-741, and within a couple of minutes you're connected to a crisis counselor. This is all text-based. It's available to anybody of any age. It can be any crisis. It doesn't have to be suicide crisis. The number one thing that we found the data with our crisis text line is that when people, one of the common things that people text about are relationship problems, which we know can be a risk factor to suicide, but it's really any kind of crisis that you're going through. It can be anything. If you just need somebody, you need an unbiased ear to talk to, and you just need somebody to kind of listen and process through what you're going through. You don't really feel comfortable doing it over the phone, you can text that number. And again, it's 741-741. You text the word CREEK to that number. And of course, there's the hotline number. That's the National Suicide Prevention Hotline number. And it is 1-800-273-TALK. Yeah, and you can call that number. You can even call that number if you are worried about a friend who is struggling with suicide. So it doesn't have to be you necessarily who's in the crisis. It can really be anyone. If you're worried about somebody in your life, in your family or your friend who is in a crisis, you can call that number and get some support that way as well.